Hi friends, welcome to the new series Angular Interview Concepts with Explanation. In this series, I'm going to explain some of the concepts those are most focused on Angular interviews. If you just prepare for your Angular interview like a question and answer format, it won't help you a lot. If the same question is asked differently, you may struggle. Instead, if you understand the core concept behind that, you'll not forget forever and you can easily answer. That is what I'm trying to explain with some examples. Let's start. One of my favorite interview questions in Angular is, what is the difference between ngOnChanges and ngDoCheck? When I ask this question in interviews, 9 out of 10 candidates answer this question wrongly. Few candidates explain in the way it is mentioned in the Angular documentation. But if I give a scenario and ask, they will tell wrongly. Let me explain the scenario to you. Assume I have created a new Angular application in which I have only the app component. Now I am having a text box in the app component HTML, and I am binding the input event to a function in the TypeScript. I am also implementing both onChanges and doCheck interfaces. Now if I type something in the input field, ngOnChanges will be called, or ngDoCheck will be called, or both will be called, or none will be called. Pause this video and think of your answer. Actually, in this case, only ngDoCheck will be called, because ngDoCheck will be called for every change reduction run. But ngOnChanges will be called only when the data bound input properties changes. Here is what people get confused. They are assuming when there is an input value change, ngOnChanges will be called. But the reality is ngOnChanges will be called only when there is a child component and child component receives a value from parent using @inputDecorator. That is what data bound input property means. Let me explain this using an example. Like the scenario I explained before, I have created a new Angular application in which I just have an app component. In the HTML, I have an input container. Inside that, I have an input box. In the TypeScript component, I'm implementing both onChanges and doCheck interfaces and use the respective functions. Inside ngOnChanges, I'm pushing a text onChanges is triggered into a logs array. Similarly, inside ngDoCheck, I'm pushing doCheck is triggered. In HTML, I'm using ng for to loop through this logs array and displaying below this input container. So you can see this. Here you can see doCheck is triggered twice. doCheck will be called once after ngOnInit during the first run. And as we are running in development mode, we can see this twice. Now if I type, we can see only ngDoCheck is triggered. ngOnChanges is not triggered. Let me create a child component and use that in our app component. Let me copy this text container and paste it in child component. Let me change the title. And let me also copy this CSS and copy these functions too. Let me invert the colors so that you can see a difference. Now also, if I type, we can see only ngDoCheck is triggered, because we haven't used @input binding yet. Let me add that. Now also, if I type, we can see only ngDoCheck is triggered because we have used @input binding, but its value is not changing. Let me pass the input from app component. I'm going to use this value. Now you can see onChanges is triggered once during the first run, and if I type something here, we can see onChanges is triggered, and then doCheck is triggered. In app component, if I comment this line, we can see onChanges is triggered during first run, but if I type, onChanges will not be triggered, because this input value is not changing now. A question to you. Instead of declaring this as string, let me declare this as an array of string. And in app component, let me push the value. Now you can see onChanges is triggered. But if I type, what will happen? Only doCheck will be triggered, because we are pushing a new value to an existing array. So the array reference is not getting changed. Therefore, onChanges will not be triggered in this case. Hope you understood the difference now. Please subscribe to my channel and support me. I'll be back with another concept soon. Thank you. Bye.